Hi everyone, welcome to Daily 中文每日中文。Today, I'm going to talk about how to ask questions in Chinese. In this video, we will learn some commonly used question words and different types of questions, including special questions using question word, tag questions, alternative questions, and affirmative-negative questions.I will focus on word order and sentence patterns to help you better understand sentence structure. 语法点一 Chinese has no case marking on pronouns. The interrogative pronoun 谁 can be used as a subject or object to raise questions or to introduce relative clauses. For example, 谁是你最好的朋友呢? Who is your best friend? You can also ask,你最好的朋友是谁？例句二，你最喜欢的运动员是谁 ？Who's your favorite athlete? Or you can ask, 谁是你最喜欢的运动员？例句三，你知道谁发明了纸吗 ？The question, 谁发明了纸 is embedded between 知道 and 吗 ？The question, 谁发明了纸吗 is wrong.You can ask, 谁发明了纸?你能认出那个人是谁吗? The question, 那个人是谁? is embedded between 认出 and 吗? 这是谁做的? Who did this? 这是谁做的?谁告诉你的? Who told you that? 谁告诉你的? In Chinese, 谁 can be used as a subject or object to raise questions.语法点二 In English, whom can be used instead of who as the object of a verb. In Chinese, the interrogative pronoun 谁 can be used as both a subject and an object. For example, 警方怀疑谁 Whom do the police suspect? 警方怀疑谁你要找谁 Whom do you want to talk to? 你要找谁他们邀请谁了? Whom do they invite? 他们邀请谁了? 我们应该相信谁呢? Whom should we believe? 我们应该相信谁呢? Subject plus verb plus 谁? is used as a relative pronoun.To ask about which person owns or is responsible for something, just like whose in English. For example, 那是谁的房子? Whose house is that? You can also ask, 那座房子是谁的?这是谁的包? You can answer, 这是我的包. This is my bag. 这块表是谁的? Whose watch is it?是我的 it's mine. 这辆车是谁的 whose car is it? 或者这是谁的车这是谁的书 whose book is this? 你也可以说这本书是谁的她是谁的女儿她是张老师的女儿 she's teacher Zhang's daughter. The sentence pattern is pronoun 是谁的 plus object, or subject 是谁的。The structure 多 plus adjective is used to ask various questions. For example, 从你家到学校有多远? How far is it from your home to school? 很近。走路五分钟就到了。你多大了? How old are you? 或者可以问,你几岁了?几岁了 is used to ask the age less than 10. 你母亲多大岁数了? How old is your mother? 多大岁数了?您多大年纪了? 多大年纪了？他任职有多久了？ How long has he held office? 三年了。你有多高？有多重？我1.73米，65公斤。有多 plus adjective。语法点五，多大 can also raise a question to ask to what extent. For example, 这种新疗法将会有多大成效？疗法 treatment, 多大成效？ How successful? 他们的行为造成了多大影响？多大影响？ How much impact? 你在多大程度上信任他？在多大程度上 ,to what extent? 这在多大程度上符合实际情况？符合实际情况 ,in line with the actual situation, 在多大程度上 ,to what extent? 环境在多大程度上对健康造成影响 ?How significant is the impact of environment on health?你也可以问环境对健康的影响有多大。The sentence structure 多大 plus noun 在多大程度上 to what extent? 语法点六，多久 or 多长时间 can be used after the verb to ask about the duration of time.Meaning, how long, what duration? For example, 你等了多久了? How long have you been waiting? 你等了多久了? 离吃午饭还有多久? When do we have lunch? 还有多久? 这样的天气还会持续多久? 持续, last. How long will this weather last?这样的天气还会持续多久？养成新的习惯需要多长时间？ How long does it take to form a new habit? 养成新的习惯需要多长时间？你打算待多长时间？ How long did you plan to stay? 你打算待多长时间？你结婚多长时间了? How long have you been married? 你结婚多长时间了? Verb plus 多久 or verb plus 多长时间。语法点七，The interrogative pronoun 多少 is used to ask about quantity of subject or object. The question expects a number greater than 10 in the answer. For example, 这幅画值多少钱? How much is this painting worth? 这幅画值多少钱? 去北京的飞机票多少钱? How much is the flight ticket to Beijing?去北京的飞机票多少钱？多少钱 can be used directly as a predicate in a sentence. 你身上带着多少现金？ How much cash do you have on you? 你身上带着多少现金？请问这个地方的租金是多少？ How much is the rent for this place? 你也可以问租这个地方要多少租金？租金是多少？要多少租金？那家公司有多少员工？ How many employees are there in the company? 那家公司有多少员工？你今年修多少门课？ How many subjects are you taking this year? 你今年修多少门课？The sentence pattern is verb plus 多少 plus measure word phrase. The interrogative pronoun 及 is used to ask about the quantity of subject or object. The question expects a number less than 10 in the answer. For example, 你吃了几块西瓜? How many pieces of watermelon did you eat? 你吃了几块西瓜? 你家有几口人? 口 is a measure word.你家有几口人?你有几个孩子? How many children do you have? 我有两个儿子。I have two sons. 你一天刷几次牙? How often do you brush your teeth a day? 你一天刷几次牙?请问你有几件行李? How many luggages do you have? 请问您有几件行李?五加三等于几? How much is 5 plus 3? 五加三等于几? Verb plus 几 plus measure word and noun. 语法点九。The interrogative pronoun 及 can be used with time words to ask date or time. For example, 今天星期几? What day is today? 今天星期天, today is Sunday. 今天几号? What's the date today? 今天几号? 你的生日是哪年?几月几日? You don't ask几年几月几日? When used in a question, 几年 means how many years? 现在几点了? What time is it now? 现在七点四十八。It is 7:48. 他们几时回来? When will they come back? 几时 means when. 你哪天回来? When are you coming back?你几天回来? This sentence is wrong. When used in a question, 几天 means how many days? 几 can be used with time words to ask date or time. 语法点十。The interrogative pronouns, 哪儿?And 哪里 are used to ask about location, meaning where. 哪儿 is more often used in spoken language. For example, 你的小猫去哪儿了? Where is your kitten? 你的小猫去哪儿了? 那家饭店在哪里? Where is that restaurant? 那家饭店在哪里? 他在哪儿? Where is he? 他在哪儿?天知道 God knows. 5月21日下午你在哪里 ?5 月21日下午你在哪里那件衣服你是在哪里买的 ?Where did you buy that dress? 你也可以问你在哪里买的那件衣服那种气味是从哪儿来的Where's that smell coming from? 从 means from. The sentence pattern is subject plus verb plus 哪儿 or 哪里。哪儿 or 哪里 can also be used in a prepositional phrase. 第十一个语法点 The prepositional phrases 在哪儿 and 在哪里。Can be placed before the predicate to ask where something take place. For example, 你在哪儿买衣服? Where do you buy clothes? 你在哪儿买衣服? 他在哪儿学汉语? Where does he learn Chinese? 他在哪儿学汉语? 你在哪里工作? Where do you work? 你在哪里工作? subject plus 在哪儿 or 在哪里 plus predicate. 哪个 or 哪些 can be used in questions in which there is a fixed or limited set of possibilities. 哪个 is a singular form of which, and 哪些 is a plural form of which. For example, 你喜欢哪个水果? Which fruit do you like? 哪个水果?哪个队赢了? Which team won? 哪个队? Which team? 你指的是哪些部分?哪些部分? Which parts? 你参加哪个职位的面试? Which post? 哪个职位?除了篮球,你还做哪些运动? What other sports do you play? 你还做哪些运动?你顺着那边的过道走,哪个过道? Which one? 哪个 is a singular form of which? And 哪些 is a plural form of which?第十三条语法点 The structure 哪 plus measure word phrase can be used in questions in which there is a fixed or limited set of answers. For example, 我应该走哪条路? Which way should I go? 你走哪条路都没关系。It doesn't matter which way you go. 你喜欢哪一本书? Which book do you like? 哪一本书? Which book?哪张画是你画的？哪张画 ？Which picture？ 我该穿哪件衣服呢？哪件衣服 ？Which dress？ 游泳和网球哪种运动比较好？哪种运动 ？Which sport？ The structure 哪 plus measure word plus noun can raise a question.第十四条语法点 有 can be used with question words to form interrogative sentences. For example, 你有哪些爱好? What are your hobbies? 你有哪些爱好? 他对这消息有何反应? What was his reaction to the news? 有谁想参加乒乓球比赛?Who are interested in a ping pong competition? 有谁想参加乒乓球比赛?空手道和功夫有什么区别? What's the difference between karate and kung fu? 你们学校有多少学生? How many students are there in your school? 你们学校有多少学生?你有几个孩子? How many children do you have?你有几个孩子?有 can be used with question words. 第十五条语法点 The adverb 到底 or 究竟 can be used with a question word to raise a question, emphasizing that you are very surprised, annoyed,confused or angry about something. For example, 他究竟为什么这么紧张?究竟为什么? Why on earth? 电视对儿童究竟有什么影响?究竟有什么影响?这究竟是怎么回事? What's all this about? 这究竟是怎么回事?你到底是谁?Who the hell are you? 你到底是谁?他到底上哪儿去了?他到底上哪儿去了?他到底对你说了什么? What did she tell you anyway? The adverb 到底 or 究竟 can be used with a question word to emphasize that you are very surprised, annoyed, confused, or angry about something. The conjunction 还是 can raise an alternative question that presents two or more possible answers. 还是 is placed before the last options. To answer a 还是 question, simply select the option that you prefer. 请问您借书还是还书？Do you borrow books or return books? 请问您借书还是还书？请问您借书或者还书？这个句子是错的。Don't confuse 还是 with 或者。或者 is used in a statement. 你喜欢这些图样还是那些？我更喜欢这些。你赞成还是反对我的提议？我反对。他真病了还是装的？他真病了还是装的？他真病了。这是真的吗？还是我在做梦？这是真的。我该走路、乘公车还是坐出租车？你坐出租车吧。To answer a 还是 question, simply select the option that you prefer. 还是 can raise an alternative question that presents two or more possible answers. The structure 是还是 is used to list different possibilities in an alternative question.It indicates an or relationship. The first 是 can be omitted in the sentence. For example, 这是对还是错? Is it right or wrong? 这是对还是错? 你来还是不来? Are you coming or not? 来还是不来? 这是副本还是正本? Is it a copy or the original?这是副本还是正本？你的杯子是满的还是空的？ Is your cup full or empty? 你的杯子是满的还是空的？我正在考虑是吃鱼还是吃牛肉。 To have fish or beef? 是吃鱼还是吃牛肉？你怎样去北京？是乘飞机？还是坐火车？是乘飞机还是坐火车？是 A 还是 B? 是还是 is used to list different possibilities in an alternative question. 第十八条语法点 The modal particle 呢can be used with 还是 to form an alternative question. 还是 connects the choices and 呢 expresses the interrogative tone. For example, 你是喝茶呢还是喝咖啡? Would you like tea or coffee? 喝茶呢还是喝咖啡? 我们步行呢还是坐公车? Shall we walk or take bus?步行呢还是坐公车？这是个意外呢还是他故意干的？这是个意外呢还是他故意干的？答案是零，小于零还是大于零呢？答案是零，小于零还是大于零呢？还是 connects the choices and the modal particle 呢expresses the interrogative tone. 第十九条语法点 The structure verb plus bu plus verb can be used to raise an affirmative-negative question. For example, 你来不来我家? You don't say, 你来不来我家吗? The modal particle 吗 cannot be used at the end of an affirmative-negative question. You can also ask,你来我家吗?请问小王在不在? Is 小王 here? 请问小王在不在?你去不去图书馆? Are you going to the library?
你去不去图书馆？
你玩不玩游戏？
Do you play games?
你玩不玩游戏？
你喜不喜欢他？
Do you like him or not?
你喜不喜欢他？
If the verb is a double syllable word, the second syllable in the affirmative part is often omitted, such as
喜不喜欢？
你知不知道他是谁？
你知不知道他是谁？
Verb plus bu plus verb can be used to raise an affirmative-negative question. The 20 条语法点 The structure adjective plus bu plus adjective can be used to raise an affirmative-negative question. For example,
他跑得快不快？
他跑得快不快吗?
It's a wrong sentence.
You can also ask, 他跑得快吗?
他唱歌唱得好不好?
你也可以说,他唱歌唱得好吗?
你累不累?
Are you tired?
你累不累?
你现在高不高兴? If the adjective is a double syllable word, the second syllable in the affirmative part is often omitted.
高不高兴?
这个你读起来清不清楚?
Is it clear enough for you to read?
读起来清不清楚?
他与同学们相处得好不好?
Did she get on well with her classmates?
他与同学们相处得好不好?
The sentence pattern is adjective plus bu plus adjective.第21条语法点有没有 is the affirmative-negative form of you sentence. It can be used to ask questions like Did you? Have you ever? Or is there any? For example,
这座城市有没有大学?
Is there a university in this city?
这座城市有没有大学?
你有没有别的解决办法?
Do you have an alternative solution?
你有没有别的解决办法?
你有没有养宠物?
Do you have any pets?
你有没有养宠物?
你有没有准备水果?
Have you prepared fruits?
你有没有准备水果?
The affirmative negative form of you sentence.
有没有?第22条语法点 The affirmative-negative form 想不想 or 要不要 can be used to ask about the desire or need. For example,
你要不要喝点什么?
Do you want to drink something?
你要不要喝点什么?
我要不要带一些食物?
Shall I bring some food?
我要不要带一些食物?
你想不想看电影?
Do you want to watch a movie?
你想不想看电影?
你想不想和我一起去图书馆?
Do you want to go to the library with me?
你想不想和我一起去图书馆? The sentence pattern is subject plus 想不想 or 要不要 plus verb.第23条语法点 In an affirmative-negative question, 是不是 can be placed at three positions. Before the predicate, as a beginning or as the end of a sentence. For example,
今天天气真好,是不是?
It is a nice day, isn't it?
今天天气真好,是不是?
这些天他是不是很累?Doesn't he look tired these days?
这些天他是不是很累?
是不是每个学生都有书了? Does every student have a book?
是不是每个学生都有书了?
Three positions of 是不是 in a sentence.
the last grammar points. The affirmative-negative form of the modal verb can be used to raise questions, such as 能不能、会不会、可不可以、etc. For example, 你能不能来吃饭?你能不能来吃饭? You don't say 你能来不来吃饭? When a question contains a modal verb, it can only use the affirmative negative form of the modal verb, not that of other verbs.
他会不会开车? Can he drive or not? 他会不会开车? 你敢不敢对我说实话?
Dare you tell me the truth?
你敢不敢对我说实话?你可不可以把文件传真给我?
Could you fax me the document?
你可不可以把文件传真给我?我应不应该和我的同事谈这件事?
Should I talk to my colleagues about it?
我应不应该和我的同事谈这件事?没有空桌子了。你愿不愿意和别人合作?
Would you mind sharing?
你愿不愿意和别人合作?
The affirmative negative form of the modal verbs.
Now we have learned 24 grammar points about interrogative sentences. Grammar points, formulas of word order, and example sentences will help you do better on sentence structure and pattern. To master the language, a lot of practice is still a necessity. If you like this video, please comment, share, like, or subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time. 感谢你收看我的视频，我们下次再见。